everyone. Hi, my beautiful families and friends. You are highly welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to the month of December, the last month of the year. Yes, in this month, I want you to know that you are blessed. You are highly favored and your case is settled. In Jesus' name, for those of you that have been with me since January, I really want to appreciate you, honestly speaking. I don't know you in person, but I'm saying thank you for being with me. May the Lord God Almighty bless you and richly replace your pause in Jesus' name. Yes, guys, it is the last month of the year. And as God gives the grace, whatsoever that is remaining, I will be sharing with you. All you will just do me a favor of practicalizing them after watching this video, irrespective of your busy schedule. Or your busy schedule, sorry, practicalize them, because I'm going to make it to be so simple for you to do. Okay, yes, guys, to my return subscribers, thank you for always coming back to watch my video. I really do appreciate. So those of you that is coming across my face or see my video for the very first time, my name is Mercy and I'm the queen of positivity. Yes, assurance covers you that this recipe is going to work for you. How do you remove the strength of your enemies? How do you reduce your enemies to nothing? How do you empty their powers? How do you render them impotent, render them useless? Is what we are going to be talking about. Please, if you like this content, stay with me, stay tuned, watch this video to the end because it's going to help you. Yes, guys, who are your enemies? They are invisible. They are no, but they exist. They torment you. They are walking. They are battling you. They are oppressing you down. They don't want you to move forward because they have been existing before your creation. Yes, guys, you don't know them, but you know they are acting. We don't catch witch with your eyes, okay? But with your spiritual eyes, you know who is who. How do you remove the strengths of your enemy? How do you render your enemy powerless in this last month of the year? You don't want them to continue fighting you in 2022. You will do this. You don't want their power to still be higher. You will do it because he said in his word, he said he will make you stronger than your enemy. He will put your enemy under your feet. Okay, yes. Once God has made those provisions for you, you just need to grab the opportunity and use it for your own good. Okay. He said one of his words that in the hand of the Lord there is cup and the wine in his gold. He said when he poured the wine, the enemy will go and finish it off. That's why you are crying, nothing is working. God is releasing blessing on a daily basis. But the enemy has sworn that you will never get anything. That's why they block the blessings. Anything can be your blessing. It can be your peace you are looking for. It can be healing, internal, physical healing you are looking for. It can be business, you want an open door. You don't really want too much money, but let them be a way so that you are moving, your business is growing. It can be life partner. It can be children. Anything can be what you are looking for. And what the enemy does is to block that particular thing that will give you joy. Because when you have full joy, serving God will be so easy for you. Challenges always make us to look as if where is this causing? Okay. So don't bother yourself. This month, are they planning or anytime they plan? Anytime you see this video, please try and practicalize it. It gives me joy when you come to me, say, Mama Mercy, I do this recipe, than to watch and rush to come to me and start sharing me your problem. I watch your video on YouTube and come to tell your problem. Don't be coming to tell me your problem when you have not check on my videos to practice one and liberate yourself. The one you liberate yourself is much better. Because if tomorrow you are faced with that challenges, or your sister, or your brother, you will share with them. Please do this to liberate yourself I do this, so that anyone that wants to help you will know where to start from. You don't just watch video and run and be sharing your problem or your problem. You start telling me all your problems, start say, give me solution, give me solution. It doesn't work like that. Yes, guys. Even me too. Every day you are doing liberation, you are delivering yourself, you are praying for your family every day because the enemy don't rest. Now, because we don't know them, it's not written on their face, I'm a witch or what or that. We don't know who they are, so we don't care to know who they are. All we know, we want to deal with them if you exist at all. If you have a hand in whatever I'm passing through, if you have a hand in my home, in my marriage, anything, I want to remove your strength. I want to strain you of your strength. I want to render you useless and powerless in this period and put you under my feet forever. I want to even put you into captivity. It's not only you putting me captive. I want to capture your enemy and put them into captivity, into lock and key. Yes, guys, I want you to take charge of your enemy. That's why I am sharing this recipe with you. Yes, guys, what we need, we need a paper. You need a paper you want to write. On that paper, you're going to write, because you don't know them by name, any man born of a woman, any woman born of a man, anything living or dead that are terrorizing my territory, that are terrorizing me and my household. All right, write your intention. You say, write the fiction. Write your intention on a piece of paper. Any spirit, be it spiritual man, be it spiritual woman, be it neighbor, unfriendly friend, whosoever you may be, that is terrorizing my life today. As I do this thing, I remove your strength and I render you powerless, impotent over me and my household in the name of Jesus. So you write it as I have pronounced. Because whether being of a man or a woman or spirit, it was given birth by male or female. When you are done writing, the next thing you need is your bottle of water. Why do we need water? Because in the beginning, the water overflowed everywhere. Water, whosoever it may be, you need water. Even if you are a spirit, whatever you may be, we are going to use water against you. And this water we are using is created by God. So we are using water against our enemy to render our enemies impotent and to strip them all their powers and make them to bow for you. After this, your enemy will bow for you and they will say of a truth, you are a child of God. Yes. You'll be stronger than your enemies in Jesus' name. So you get your bottle of water. Please, this water, I will not open it. This is fresh bottle one. So I have another one, okay? So you're going to use your water like this. This one is not full. Reason is not full. Because I can shake it vigorously. Vigorously, I'm going to shake this water so that I can touch them very well. Now, when you get your water with you, next thing is that your enemies you have written. Okay, you just put them inside this water. You just put the paper inside this water. Okay, you have put them inside this water. Next thing that you need, okay, is your a full spoon of salt. You need this salt. Which salt do I need? You need this either your cooking salt. It's your cooking salt. You need your salt is enough. If you have spiritual salt, maybe you have bought spiritual salt with me. From me, you can use your spiritual salt, okay? Because a lot of things was added into that spiritual salt to make it spiritual salt. But if you don't have your spiritual salt, you can use your cooking salt. So I'm going to be adding this salt to the water, okay? I'm going to be adding this salt to the water. Now, your spoon that you are using, the salt must be full to the brain. You must fill the salt. So I'm going to be adding this salt to the water. I've added my salt to the water. Now, if you add this salt to the water, one spoon of salt to this water, you add another one. I'm just adding one. You're going to add up to like 4, 5, 6, 7 spoons of salt. You'll be adding 1 spoon, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. If the salt will be too much because it's not going to be tasty, you add 7 spoons of salt to this water. Next thing you're going to get is your nail. This is our instrument we are going to be using. These are, look at nail. These are fresh nails. Look at fresh nails. These are fresh nails. These are your nail. Now, how many pieces of nail you have? Do you have 3? It's okay. Do you have 4? It's okay. Okay. Do you have 3? You have 4 like this. Okay. Look at, we have 3. 1, 2, and 3. It's been long I brought something like this to you. So when you have added these nails into the bottle water that has your enemy's names, that have this 7 spoons of salt and the 3 names, we're going to be reading the scripture. You'll be reading is Isaiah 49 verse 25. He said, I will contend with them that contend with you. Jeremiah chapter 51, 20 to 25. You are my battle axe. With you, I will destroy nations. I will destroy horses and their riders. Jeremiah chapter 8, Isaiah chapter 8, verse 9 and 10. Associate yourself together, you shall be broken into pieces. Take counsel, and you shall be broken into pieces. Okay, then Psalm 35, fight against them that fight against me. Battle axe. Psalm 35 is your battle axe when it comes to the book of Psalm. Another, your battle axe is also Psalm 72. Okay, so you're going to use Psalm 35 as your battle axe. Oh God. Then you cover your water. You will read those scriptures on the scripture. Rise it. Okay. Reading the scripture does not make you a Christian. So even if you are not a Christian, you're watching my video, please. It is the word of your creator, your maker, and not the word of man. And when it's the word of God, it backs whatever you're doing. Assurance covers you that it is working already. Immediately you have a positive mindset to carry out this assignment. So don't say I'm not a Christian. No. Reading the Bible is not making you a Christian. What makes you a Christian is more than that, far, far, far better than that. So you want to back it with the scriptures. Yes, I'm already feeling the presence of God. My enemies are in trouble. You see this name? You are going to shake it vigorously. Oh God, contend with any man, contend with me. Any man born of a woman, any woman born of a man, any spirit, anybody, whosoever that is celebrating my downfall, that is celebrating my barrenness, celebrating my singleness. Oh God, arise and contend with them. My dear, you're going to shake this vigorously. You're going to pray like a wounded lion because you don't want to carry that problem, that burden, that story to 2022. That is why you have to deal with them once and for all. You will shake it vigorously. You will shake it with every strength in you. You will shake it. You will rain curses. You can use Psalm 109. You will rain curses. You will rain prayers upon them. Abusive word. You will condemn them. You will destroy them. You will render them powerless. You will strip them all their powers and make them impotent forever. Okay, is this spirit of, are you experiencing barrenness? You can say, you spirit of barrenness in my life, I destroy you totally with this. You spirit of singleness in my life, I destroy you totally with this. So you can write, destroy the spirit of barrenness, destroy the spirit of singleness, destroy any cause. You can write anything you want. It must not be any man or any woman. Okay, you write it, you will shake it at any time. You're going to shake it for the periods or 7 days, minimum 3, 5, 7 days, you'll be shaking it. You'll be shaking it. If you shake it today, you are not around tomorrow. Don't, no problem. The day you are around, shake it. When you want to shake it with all the strength in you and the Holy Ghost anger. After you have done praying the days, you are satisfied with it. You can leave it even next year, but don't leave it till next year. Please, oh, don't leave it till next year. You must not carry the battle to next year. So, after you have done that, he sees this name. You're going to punch the bottles. You punch all over the bottles. Punch it with this thing. When you punch it, you will just stand. As the water is draining, you say, God, as this water is draining from this, so shall my enemy's strength be removed. I drain their strength. I remove their powers. I remove their connection. I remove their activity. I strip them of all their powers. As this water is draining, so shall their power drop. So shall their, you drain them of their powers. You remove their strength. You will drain the water. You will drink the water on the floor. Please don't drink the water in your house. So you come outside your house, you punch it, you'll be draining the water. Let the water be draining. You can also drain it in your toilet. Let it be draining. You are praying until the water empties. Once the water empty like this, please, the way you cover it with the nail, with the paper, everything, throw it like that. Don't open it again. Throw it like that. You can tie it in a black covered nylon and dispose it like that. But you must make sure you drink all the waters, okay, and dispose it like that. Use this thing to make a hole. Pam, 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 pam. Down everywhere. You will drink all their waters like this. This is how you're going to remove your enemy's strength and make them render them useless. And they will never have power over you. See, if you are doing this prayer, as you are shaking the nails, some of them will start confessing. Okay, the nails will hit them wherever they are, even if they are dead. As long as they are still operating in your life, the nails will hit them. Don't cross over to 2022 without barrenness, without singleness, without delay, without disappointment. Don't cross over 2022 without doing this recipe. And anytime you see this video, please practice your own. I'm just making this video because it's December, so you can see January, practice your own. Ensure that you drain your enemy, you remove their strength by using this method, and come and tell me after you have done the prayer if life did not turn around. Things must surely change for you. This is what I want to share with you. I hope you like it. I hope you will enjoy it. I hope you will practice it and come back with your testimony. Yes, my ears are waiting to hear your testimony. Thank you for watching. Subscribe, like, and share. Bye.